This episode of Tech Chop is brought to you by GoToMeeting and Amazon. Welcome to episode 59 of Tech Chop. I, of course, am Paul Bauer, a.k.a. twitter.com/eldepablo. In the news this week, we will talk about the next incarnation of Xbox, Apple yanks app gratis, scientists have found the missing link, New York residents can now pay rent using Bitcoin, Voodoo had a data breach, Ubuntu makes the latest beta of Raring Ringtail available, an Iranian scientist invents the time machine, and how using open source may land you your next IT job. All this and more coming up right after this. Like it or not, meetings are essential to the way we work. Sometimes a little FaceTime is needed to solve problems or to come up with new ideas. But if your team is spread out in different locations, coming together can be an impossible task. That is, unless you use GoToMeeting with HD Faces, the powerfully simple way to meet and collaborate online. The sales team at my company uses GoToMeeting all the time to make their pitches to potential clients all over the country. It helps to give a face to the person on the other side of the phone, and allows us to share screens and presentations so they can make better decisions when it comes to buying our products. Doesn't matter where people are, as long as they have access to the internet, because GoToMeeting allows you to share the same screen, making it easier to be on the same page. And with built-in HD video conferencing, you can see each other face-to-face. Plus, it's so easy to launch or join a meeting from anywhere using your computer, phone, or tablet. And now you can even present from your iPad. Try GoToMeeting free for 30 days. For this special offer, visit GoToMeeting.com, click on the Try It Free button, and use the promo code PODCAST. Remember, use the promo code PODCAST so they know that Tech Chop sent you. GoToMeeting. Meeting is believing. Welcome back, and now for this week's stories. Microsoft is expected to announce the much-anticipated next generation of their Xbox gaming console. Some are saying that the name of the new console will be called simply Xbox. Other reports say that people are concerned that this new version will have to be left on all the time and must be constantly connected to the internet. Eurogamer says, quote, "Recently leaked internal documentation dated to last year referenced the console's always-on, always-connected design. There are going to be two new versions of the new Xbox console. Some are saying that the higher-end model is going to be costing around $500, and a less expensive subscription-based model will only cost around $300. The popular iPhone app, AppGratis, that offers discounted pricing on popular paid apps in the Apple App Store, has been pulled off the market by Apple. This comes after reports that AppGratis was given $13.5 million in funding from Iris Capital and Orange Public Fund in January. PC Mag said, quote, "Unfortunately, its business model runs afoul of some of Apple policies." Back in October, Apple updated its app guidelines to say that apps that display apps other than your own for purchase or promotion in a manner similar to or confusing with the App Store will be rejected. This is a huge blow to AppGratis, who had just topped the 10 million user mark back in February. A new study released in Current Biology from Thor Bergman, who's an assistant professor with the University of Michigan, said that the missing link between humans and monkeys has been discovered. Well, at least in the way that we talk. Bergman said that while studying gelada baboons in the Ethiopian highlands, that oftentimes when hearing their chatter, he thought he heard people talking. The Register said, quote, "Researchers analyzed the distinctive lip-smacking sounds made by wild gelada baboons of the Ethiopian highlands and found striking similarities to human speech." Bergman noted in the study that other species of monkeys smack their lips when eating, for instance, but gelada baboons were the only ones that did it while communicating with each other. There was another interesting scientific discovery. Apparently, an Iranian scientist named Ali Razighi has invented friggin' time travel. Yeah, I didn't stutter. I said friggin' time travel. The device called the Aryayek time traveling machine was registered with the Iranian state-run Center for Strategic Inventions. The Telegraph said, quote, "Razighi, 27, said the device worked by a set of complex algorithms to predict 5 to 8 years of the future life of any individual, with 98% accuracy." So the device isn't as cool as, say, the DeLorean from Back to the Future, as it won't actually allow you to travel between certain points in time. All it does is makes predictions of possible future events with a very high rate of accuracy. Well, I guess that's a start. Bitcoin users living in New York may be happy to know that apartments and condos that are managed by Alvic Property Management will now be accepting payments via Bitcoin. This is the first property management company to accept the digital cryptocurrency. PRWeb said, quote, "All properties managed by Alvik Property Management are currently accepting Bitcoins. Residents initially need to reach out to their property manager to have their account enabled to accept Bitcoin. They will then be able to make payments to a Bitcoin address exclusive to their account." This is great news for those hoping that Bitcoin will go mainstream, which is nice because there was a huge hit to Bitcoin last week when the price plummeted from $266 down to $105. Some are speculating that it was caused from central banks like the Federal Reserve conducting a stress test by conducting a mass sell-off of the currency in an attempt to cause users to lose confidence. The online video streaming service Vudu that is owned by Walmart recently had a data breach that prompted them to force password changes for many of their users. The data breach wasn't the fault of any elite hackers either. It was the fault of some burglars who actually broke into Vudu's offices and stole a bunch of items, including a hard drive that contained user information. TechSpot said, quote, "The Walmart-owned video streaming services investigation has revealed that the stolen drives held customers' names, email addresses, postal addresses, dates of birth, phone numbers, account activity, and the last four digits of some credit card numbers. The good news is that the hard drives didn't have full credit card numbers, but still, the company is offering free identity protection from All Clear ID for 1 year to affected users." Ubuntu Linux is getting closer to their final release of Ubuntu 13.04, aka Raring Ringtail. Ubuntu has released their latest beta versions of Raring Ringtail if you just cannot wait for the new awesomeness. OMG Ubuntu says that the new features are new shutdown and session exit dialogues, new sync menu for Ubuntu One, faster, more performant Unity, new interface animations, including Windows Snap, and scroll switching of open windows from Unity Launcher. Along with this release will be a new fork of Ubuntu called Ubuntu GNOME, which may be more familiar for users who have been using Ubuntu for a long time, like me, that can't stand the Unity interface. In our final story this week, you may be happy to learn that if you're a user of open source tools and freeware, then automated resume bots might be looking for you. Doing things as simple as using an alternative browser than the one that comes stock with your operating system, sort of like how Internet Explorer comes with Windows, is being seen as a sign of efficiency. The Economist said, quote, "In the case of hiring American workers who toil by the hour, number crunching has uncovered some surprising correlations. For instance, people who fill out online job applications using browsers that did not come with their computers, such as Microsoft's Internet Explorer on a Windows PC, but had to be deliberately installed, like Firefox or Google's Chrome, perform better and change jobs less often." So I guess all those hours of watching Tech Shop and reading Bower Power haven't gone to waste, right? It may have just given you the edge you need in your next job search. Speaking of freeware, stay tuned after this for our freeware pick of the week.
Need a new computer? Amazon has it. Need some toilet paper? Amazon has it. Want to read the latest best-selling book? Amazon has it. Amazon is literally your one-stop shop for everything you could possibly ever want online. They also resell items from some of your favorite online retailers like Tiger Direct, except oftentimes with no taxes and cheaper shipping. Plus, if you sign up with Amazon Prime with a low cost of only $79 per year, you get free 2-day shipping on millions of different items. Everything is delivered right to your door. No more driving to the store for your odds and ends, taking away from valuable Xbox time. Shop in your underwear like you always wanted to do. Go to amazon.techchop.com. You'll get the same experience and prices, plus a small percentage of your purchase goes to help out Tech Chop. It's win-win for everybody. Visit amazon.techchop.com now and get your Amazon shop on. Bookmark amazon.techchop.com for all your future purchases and continue to help out the show. That's amazon.techchop.com.
This week's freeware pick of the week is Recova from Pyraform. It's a freeware utility to restore files that have been accidentally deleted from your computer. This includes files emptied from the recycle bin, as well as images and other files that have been deleted by user error from digital camera memory cards or MP3 players. It'll even bring back files that have been deleted from your iPod
or by bugs, crashes, and viruses. It's certainly a lifesaver that saved my butt 100 times. That's all I have this week. As always, if you have something to say or a question asked, sound off below or hit us up on our Facebook page. Remember, there's a new episode every week, so be sure to like, fave, subscribe, and we'll see you next time right here on Tech Chop. Tech Chop is a proud member of the Tech Podcast Network. TechPodcasts.com. If it's tech, it's here.